Dear students, welcome to Ishikshana program. In my last class, I started discrete probability distributions, in particular binomial distribution, As I told you, binomial distribution is a widely used distribution for a discrete random variable and helps us to compute probability of success or failure outcomes in an experiment or survey that is repeated specific number of times. I considered few examples in my last class, and today also I'll continue with some examples on binomial probability distribution. So let me consider this example. The problem is, if the chance means probability, if the chance that one of the 10 telephone lines is busy at an instant is 0.2, what is the chance that 5 lines are busy? Second question, what is the chance that at most 2 lines are busy? Third question, what is the chance that all the lines are busy? So it is given that the probability that one of the telephone lines is busy at an instant is 0.2. So probability P is given to be 0.2. Here the random variable is number of telephone lines busy. 10 telephone lines. So N is given. N is given. The two parameters of binomial probability distribution are N and P. So N is given to be 10 and P is given to be 0.2. So therefore, with the help of these two parameters, we can construct the probability mass function of binomial probability distribution. And later we can find these probabilities. Okay. So let the random variable X denote the number of telephone lines are busy. So it is given that one of the telephone lines is busy at an instant is 0.2. That means given P is 0.2. So therefore, you can calculate the Q as 1 minus P, complement of P, 1 minus P, that is equal to 0.8. And here N is 10. So parameter N is 10, parameter P is 0.2. So therefore, we can construct the probability mass function of binomial distribution as P of X is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R Q power N minus R. Substituting for N, P and Q, we obtain P of R, X is equal to R. So we can write P of R directly is equal to NCR P is 0.2. So 0.2 power R, and Q is 0.8, so 0.8 power 10 minus R. So question number one, what is the chance is probability. What is the probability that 5 lines are busy? Exactly 5 lines. That means the random variable R, X is equal to R, should take the value 5. So therefore, probability of 5 lines are busy is P of R is equal to 5. That is probability of R 5 lines busy is equal to replace R by 5 in this relation. So 10C5 0.2 power 5 0.8 power 10 minus 5. If you calculate using calculator, we get the numerical value 0.0264. So therefore, probability of 5 lines are busy is 0.0264. The next problem, what is the probability or a chance that at most 2 lines are busy? At most means less than or equal to. So that means we need to calculate the probability of R less than or equal to 2. So probability of at most 2 lines are busy is probability of R less than or equal to 2 is equal to P of 0, probability of 0, plus probability of 1 line busy, no lines are busy, plus probability of two lines are busy. So this is equal to, so substitute R is equal to 0, R is equal to 0 here, 10C 0, 0.2 power 0, 0.8 power 10 minus 0. 10C 0, 0.2 power 0, 0.8 power 10 minus 0. Similarly, plus R is equal to 1, 10C 1, 0.2 power 1, plus 0.8 power 10 minus 1. For P of 2, that is probability of two lines are busy, 10C 2, 0.2 power 2, R is 2, so 2, 0.8 power 10 minus R, that is 10 minus 2. So if you compute this using calculator, so the first term will reduce to 0.1073, plus this term is calculated to 0.2684, and the third term the numerical gives the numerical value 0.3019. When we sum all the three, we get 0.6776. So therefore, probability of at most 10 lines are busy is 0.6776. The third question, what is the chance that all the lines are busy? So all the 10 lines are busy. That means R should be equal to 10, because R denotes number of telephone lines busy. What is the probability that all the lines are busy means? So we have to find the probability of R is equal to 10. So that is equal to replace R by 10 in the probability mass function of this problem. P of R is equal to 10 C R, 0.2 power R, 0.8 power 10 minus R. Replace R by 10. So 10C 10, 0.2 power 10, 0.8 power 10 minus 10. So that is what is written here. 10C 10, 0.2 power 10, 0.8 power 10 minus 10. So when you calculate, you get the value 1.024 into 10 power minus 7. So small probability. The probability, therefore, probability of all the lines are busy is 1.024 into 10 power minus 7. So, next question. The next question is, in a bombing action, there is 50% chance that any bomb will strike the target. Two direct hits are needed to destroy the target completely. How many bombs are required to be dropped to give a 99% chance or better? That means 99% chance or more of completely destroying the target. The problem is this. In a bombing action, there is 50% chance that any bomb will strike the target. So the probability of a bomb striking the target is given to be 50%. That means 0.5 or 1 by 2. Two direct hits are needed to destroy the target completely. Okay, so two direct hits are required to destroy the target completely means dropping the bombs to destroy the target completely may not serve the purpose, because the chance of a bomb hitting the target is only 50%. So these two, only two are dropped, may or may not hit the target, or may not destroy the target completely. So therefore, we need to drop more number of bombs, that is minimum two or more number of bombs to be dropped. What is the minimum number of bombs to be dropped to give 99% chance or better of completely destroying the target is the question. So we need to find minimum number of bombs to be dropped to give 99% chance or better or more of completely destroying the target. So here in this question, we need to find the number of bombs, that is one of the parameter of binomial distribution. So here what is given is P is given, probability of a bomb striking the target 50%, that is 1 by 2 or 0.5, and N need to be calculated with the help of this condition, 99% chance or better of completely destroying the target. This is the main aim of the question. Okay. In the solution part, let us write down what all is given. The probability of a bomb striking the target is given as 50%. That is, P is equal to 0.5. Therefore, Q can be calculated as 1 minus P is equal to 0.5. So, P is known, Q from the complement of P is known. Now, we have to calculate N, the number of bombs. Okay. So, with this P and Q, we can write the binomial probability distribution or probability mass function of binomial distribution as in terms of N, P of X is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R Q power N minus R. R replacing P by 0.5, Q by 0.5. So it is P of R is equal to the probability of R success. So here the random variable, number of bombs that strike the target. So P of R is equal to NCR 0.5 power R into 0.5 power N minus R. So when you simplify this, you get P of R is equal to NCR into 0.5 power N. So this R and minus R get cancelled. You get only 0.5 power N. So here N is the number of bombs that is to be calculated. Minimum N is to be calculated. Okay, since at least two bombs are required to destroy the target completely, the probability that at most N bombs would destroy the target is probability of 2 less than or equal to R less than or equal to N. So we need to calculate this because we need minimum 2 or more. So how much is more, that is to be decided by this N. So we need to calculate probability of 2 less than or equal to R less than or equal to N. So writing this, this can be written as probability of 2 bombs hitting the target, probability of 3 hitting the target, 4, etc. probability of N number of bombs. So substitute R is equal to 2 here, NC2 0.5 power 2 0.5 power N minus 2. So here NC2 0.5 power N. So this comes as a constant. So NC2 0.5 power N plus NC3 0.5 power N, etc. The last one, NCN 0.5 power N. So this 0.5 power N can be taken outside. So 0.5 power N into NC2 plus NC3 plus NC4 plus NC5, etc. plus NCN. So this is equal to, so 0.5 is 1 by 2 power N, and this reduces to 2 power N minus 1 minus N. So this is explained here. So how NC2 to NCN reduces to 2 power N minus 1 minus N. So add and subtract NC0 and NCN to this. So NC0 plus NCN, this entire thing, minus NC0 minus NC1. So I have added NC0 and subtracted NC0, and I have added NC1 and subtracted NC1. So from here to here, N plus 1 terms, 1 to N plus 1 more. So N plus 1 terms is nothing but binomial expansion of 1 plus 1 raised to the power N, because all coefficients 1, 1, 1, 1. So that makes 1 plus N power N. So this is nothing but binomial expansion of 1 plus 1 power N. NC0 is 1, so minus 1. NC1 is N, so minus N. So 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 power N minus 1 minus N. Okay, so this reduces to 2 power N minus 1 minus 1, as I just have explained. So now this is 1 by 2 power N. So if you take it inside, so 1 by 2 power N into 2 power N, that makes 1 minus of 1 plus N divided by 2 power N. So this probability of 2 less than or equal to r less than or equal to n, where n is number of bombs. As per the given condition, how many bombs are required to be dropped to give a 99% chance or better of completely destroying the target means this probability should be greater than or equal to 99%. For 99% or better of destroying the target, we have this probability 1 minus 1 plus n by 2 power n, that is 1 minus 1 plus n by 2 power n, should be greater than or equal to 99%, that means 99 by 100. So taking this to left hand side and sending this to the RHS, so this makes 1 minus 99 by 100 or 100 minus 99 by 100, that is 1 by 100, greater than or equal to 1 plus n by 2 power n, or 1 plus n by 2 power n is less than or equal to 1 by 100. Or cross multiplying 100 into 1 plus n, 100 into 1 plus n less than or equal to 1 into 2 power n. So now we need to calculate this n for which this is valid. So this is by trial and error method. So this I have explained the separate sheet. So here, okay. So this is the point here, 100 into 1 plus n less than or equal to 2 power n. So we have to give arbitrarily values to n, 2, 3, 5, 6, I started with 9 here. Let us see for what value of this n, this is balanced or satisfied. So for n is equal to 9, so 9 plus 1, 10, 10 into 100, 1000. And here 2 power 9 is 512, so this is a bigger number, so not less than or equal to 502. Next number, n is equal to 10, 10 plus 1 is 11, so 1100, and 2 power 10 is 1024, so this is bigger number, so this is again not less than or equal to 1024. So when you put n is equal to 11, that is 12,200, and here 2 power 11 is 2048. So this is really a smaller number to this. So for n is equal to 11, this is balanced. So therefore, the minimum value of n satisfying this inequality is n is equal to 11. That means minimum of 11 bombs are required to be dropped to destroy the target 99% chance or better. Okay. So my next example is this. In a sampling, a large number of parts manufactured by a machine, the mean number of defective in a sample of 20 is 2. Out of 1000 such samples, how many would be expected to contain at least 3 defective parts? The question is, in a sampling, a large number of parts manufactured by a machine, the mean number of defective in a sample is 20 is 2. Out of 1000 such samples, how many would be expected to contain at least 3 defective parts? First, we have to find the probability of at least 3 defective parts with the given data, and then multiply to 10,000 to find out the how many samples would be expected to contain 3 defective parts. That is the question. So given that mean number of defective parts in a sample 20 is 2, so sample size is given, so this is our n. 20, n is 20, mean is given as 2, mean number of defective parts in a sample 20 is 2, so mean is given as 2 and n is 20, so n is 20, so mean is 2 means np is equal to 2, because mean is np, so n is 20, so p is equal to 2 by 20 will give you 0.1. Therefore, Q is equal to 1 minus P, that is 1 minus 0.1 will give you 0.9. So now the both the parameters are known, P is known, N is known. So therefore, I can clearly write the probability mass function of binomial probability distribution. So P of X is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R into Q power N minus R. So therefore, substituting for N, P and Q, P of R is equal to 20 CR, N is 20, P is 0.1, 0.1 power R, Q is 0.9, 0.9 power 20 minus R. So probability of at least three defective parts. The question is, out of 1,000 such samples, how many would be expected to contain at least three defective parts? Now let us find the probability of at least three defective parts in a sample of 20 and multiply that probability to 1,000 to find out how many out of 20,000 sample contain at least three defective parts. Okay. So probability of at least three defective parts in a sample of 20 is at least means greater than or equal to. So greater than or equal to, the random variable is greater than or equal to 3. So probability of R greater than or equal to 3 is equal to 1 minus probability of R less than 3. So this is equal to, using the complement property, 1 minus P of R strictly less than 3 is equal to 1 minus P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2. We have to stop here. So this is equal to 1 minus, substitute R is equal to 0 in the probability mass function, R is equal to 0, 20 C 0, 0.1 power 0 into 0.9 power 20 minus 0. So 20 C 0, 0.1 power 0 into 0.9 power 20 minus 0 is 20, plus when R is 1, 20 C 1, C 1, 0.1 power R, R is 0 here R is 1, and here 0.9 power 20 minus 0, that is 20 minus R, so R is 1, 20 minus 1 is 19. And similarly, P of 2, 20 C 2, 0.1 square, R is 2, and here 18, 20 minus 2, that makes 18, so 0.9 power 18. So when you calculate using calculator altogether, this will reduce to a numerical value 0.32307. So therefore, this is the probability of at least three defective parts in a sample of 20. So therefore, out of 1,000 such samples, the expected number of samples containing at least three defective parts is equal to 1,000 into this probability 0.32307. So you get 323.07. So this is approximately, because number of samples cannot be fraction, so this is approximately equal to 323 samples. Next question. The probability that a man aged 60 will live up to 70 is 0.61. What is the probability that out of 10 men now aged 60, at least 7 will live up to 70? The question is, the probability that a man aged 60 will live up to 70 is 0.65. So probability of man aged 60 will live up to 70 is given, that is P is given to be 0.65. And what is the probability that out of 10 men, so N is given to be 10, so N is 10, P is 0.65, so probability mass function can be written. Now the problem is, what is the probability that out of 10 men, now aged 60, at least 7 will live up to 70. So here random variable is men who live up to 70. Okay. The probability that a man aged 60 will live up to 70 is given to be 0.65. Therefore, P is 0.65. So Q can be calculated with the help of P, because 1 plus P plus Q is equal to 1. So Q is 1 minus P, this is equal to 1 minus 0.65, that will give you 0.35. And N, the parameter N is given to be 10 min. N is 10 min, so N is equal to 10. Therefore, we can write the probability mass function for this probability binomial distribution as P of x is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R Q power N minus R. So therefore, P of R is equal to replacing N by 10, 10 CR P by 0.65, 0.65 power R Q is 0.35. So 0.35 power N is 10, 10 minus R. So the probability that at least 7 will live up to 70, that means at least means greater than or equal to. So probability that at least 7 will live up to 70 is nothing but the probability of the random variable R greater than or equal to 7. So this is written as P of 7, 7 living up to 70, 8 living up to 70, 9 living up to 70, and 10 living up to 10 men living up to 70. So P of 7 plus P of 8 plus P of 9 plus P of 10. So substitute R is equal to 7 in this relation. When R is 7, 10C 7, 0.65 power 7, 0.35 power 10 minus 7. So that will give you 10C 7, 0.65 power 7, 0.35 power 10 minus 7, that is 3. 10 minus 7, that is 3. Similarly, P of 8, 10C 8, 0.65 power 8, 0.35 power 10 minus 8, that is 2. Similarly, P of 9, when R is equal to 9, 10C 9, 0.65 power 9, 0.35 power 10 minus 9, that is 1. Plus, similarly, when R is 10, 10C 10, 0.65 power 10 into 0.35, power 10 minus 10, that is 0. So when you simplify term wise, the first term will reduce to the numerical value 0.2522, plus the second term will reduce to the numerical value 0.1750, the third term will reduce to 0.0724, plus the fourth term will reduce to 0.0134. So when you sum all these four numbers, you get 0.49. So therefore, the probability that at least 7 will live up to 70 is 0.49. So next question. In 100 sets of 10 tosses of an unbiased coin, in how many cases should we expect 7 heads and 3 tails? Second question, at least 7 heads. In 100 sets of 10 tosses of an unbiased coin, in how many cases should we expect 7 heads? So if we calculate for 7 heads, it is as good as calculating for 7 heads and a tail, because 10 tosses means 10 locations. If 5 locations are occupied by heads, the remaining has to be occupied by tails only. So they are complement of each other. Okay. So what is the probability of a head when an unbiased coin is tossed? It is 50%. So probability of head is 50%. The probability of tail is also 50%. So that is our P. So P is obtained as 1 by 2. So N is 10. So in 100 sets of tosses, how many? That you multiply this probability to 100, you get the corresponding number of sets. So now in the solution part, in tossing an unbiased coin, probability of head is half. So let me call it as P. So therefore, Q is equal to 1 minus P is also half. They share equal probabilities, tossing a coin, head and tail, they share equal probabilities. So probability of head is half, that is p is equal to half, therefore q also is equal to half, and n is given to be 10 tosses. So 10 tosses, so n is 10 here. So therefore you can write the probability mass function of binomial distribution for this problem as p of r is equal to ncr p power r q power n minus r is equal to n is 10 here, so 10 cr. So substitute for p, p is half to the power r. Substitute for q, half to the power n is 10 minus r. So when you simplify this, you get 10 cr into 1 by 2 raised to the power 10. Okay, now, so after writing the probability mass function, the question is, what is the probability, how many cases should we expect 7 heads and 3 tails in 100 sets of 10 tosses of an unbiased coin? So first we shall find out the probability of 7 heads and 3 tails, or simply probability of 7 heads. So here the random variable is number of heads. So probability of 7 heads and 3 tails is nothing but calculating the probability of the random variable r is equal to 7. So this is equal to substitute for r 7. So p of 7, r is equal to 7, 10 c 7, 1 by 2 power 10. So if you simplify using the calculator, this will reduce to a numerical value 0.11718. so this is okay. In 100 sets of 10 tosses, the number of cases in which 7 heads and 3 tails are expected is 100 into this probability. 100 into this probability is 100 into 0.11718, that is equal to 11.71. So number of sets cannot be fraction, so this is approximated to 12. So therefore in 100 sets of 10 tosses, the number of cases in which 7 heads and 3 tails are expected is 12. The next question, at least means greater than or equal to. So probability of at least 7 heads is p of r greater than or equal to 7. This is equal to 7 to 10. So it is better to expand right this way only. If we take the complement, more calculations has to be done. So p of r greater than or equal to 7 is conveniently written as p of 7 plus p of 8 plus p of 9 plus p of 10. So this is equal to p of 7, replace r by 7 here. So 10 c 7, 1 by 2 power 10. 10 c 7, 1 by 2 power 10. So this is constant throughout. So p 8, 10 c 8, 9, 10 c 9, 10, 10 c 10. So this is a common multiple, so that can be removed outside. So 1 by 2 power 10 into 10 c 7 plus 10 c 8 plus 10 c 9 plus 10 c 10. If you use the calculator, this will reduce to 0.171875. So therefore, in 100 sets of 10 tosses, the number of cases in which at least 7 heads are expected is 100 into this probability. So 100 into 0.171875, that is equal to 17.1875. This is approximated to 17, approximately. So thus the probability, thus in 100 sets of 10 tosses, the number of cases in which at least 7 heads are expected is 17 sets. Okay, this the next problem. An airline knows that 5% of the people making reservations on a certain flight will not turn up. Consequently, their policy is to sell 52 tickets for a flight that can only hold 50 passengers. What is the probability that there will be a seat available for every passenger who turns up? The question is like this. An airline knows 5% of the people making reservations on a certain flight will not turn up. So 5% means 0.05. So consequently, their policy is to sell 52 against 50. So they sell 2 tickets extra against 50. What is the probability that there will be a seat available for every passenger who turns up? Now, the probability of a passenger who makes reservation on a certain flight will not turn up is 50%, 5%. So P is given. So this is our P. And 52 tickets, their policy is to sell 52 tickets. So this is our N. This is our N. So the probability that a passenger will not turn up is P, 5%, that is 0.05. Therefore, you can calculate Q, and N is given to be 52. So therefore, with the help of parameters N and P, the PMF of binomial distribution can be written as P of X is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R Q power N minus R. So this is equal to 52. Replace N by 52, P by 0.05 and Q by 0.95. So 0.5 power R, 0.95 power 52 minus R, because N is 52. Okay. What is the probability that there will be a seat available for every passenger who turns up? This is the question. Wait. So when there will be a seat? When 50 only available. 50 only, flight can hold only 50, but 52 tickets are sold, thinking that 5% will not turn up. So that means minimum 2 passengers should not turn up. Minimum 2 passengers should not turn up, or 2 or more. Therefore, we need to calculate the probability of R, the random variable, greater than or equal to 2. So the probability that there will be a seat for every passenger who turns up is probability of R greater than or equal to 2. So this is equal to, you can take the complement here, 1 minus probability of R less than 1 is equal to 1 minus P of 0. So P of 0, you substitute. So here 52 C0, so R is equal to 0 here. So let us introduce that here. Okay. So 1 minus P is equal to R is equal to 0. This is 52 C. Yes, C is missing here. So 52 C0, 0.540, into 0.95 power 52 minus 0. So this is equal to 0.7405. So the probability that there will be a seat for every passenger is 0.7405. Okay. The next question. Two dice are thrown 120 times. Two dice are thrown 120 times. Find the average number of times in which the number on the first die exceeds the number on the second die. Two dice are thrown 120 times. Find the average number of times in which the number on the first die exceeds the number on the second die. So this is the question. So two dice are thrown. When two dice are thrown, the total number of possible outcomes is 36. This I have discussed already in the beginning of the classes. So let us, for our convenience sake, let us take the first component coming from the first die, second component coming from the second die. So in a throw of two dice, the total number of possible outcomes is 36. That is, exhaustive number of cases is 36. So now in this problem, we need to find the average. That is, E of x we have to find. What is the probability here? The probability is the first die exceeds the number on the second die. So what are the cases that satisfies that first die exceeds the number on the second die? So you can easily make out. So in this column there is one, there is no one. So here in the second column, 2, 1. In the third column, 3, 1, 3, 2. All first die exceeds second die. First die exceeds second die. First die exceeds second die. Similarly here, first die exceeds second die. And here, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3. 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3. 6, 1, 5, 4 also. Then 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4 up to 6, 5. So the numbers on the first die exceeds that on the second die are 2, 1, 3, 1, 3, 2, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, then 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5. So favorable number of cases is 15. Exhaustive number of cases is 36. So therefore, probability of success is equal to probability of number in the first die exceeds the number in the second die. So therefore, P is equal to favorable divided by exhaustive, 15 by 36 is equal to 3 by 12. So here, N is 120. So P is known, N is known. So mean is equal to N into P. So average number EX is equal to N into P. That means 120 into P, 5 by 12, that makes 50. Okay. The incidence of occupational disease in an industry is such that the workers have 20% chance of suffering from it. What is the probability that out of 6 workers, 4 or more will come in contact of the disease? The question is, the incidence of occupational disease in an industry is such that the workers have 20% chance of suffering from it. So probability is given to be 20%. What is the probability that out of 6 workers, so N is given to be 6 workers, 4 or more will come in contact of the disease? That is, probability of random variable greater than or equal to 4, 4 or more. Okay, so in the solution part, the probability of a worker suffering from the disease is P is equal to 20%, that is 0.2, Q is 0.8, and N is 6. Therefore, probability mass function is written as P of R is equal to 6 CR, 0.2 power R into 0.8 power 6 minus R. Therefore, the probability of 4 or more will come in contact of the disease is probability of the random variable R greater than or equal to 4 is equal to PR4 plus PR5 plus PR6. So when you substitute R is equal to 4, when you substitute R is equal to 4, you get 6C4, 0.2 power 4, 0.8 power 6 minus 4. 6 minus 4. Similarly, 6C5, 0.2 power 5 plus 0.8 power 6 minus 5 plus 6C6, 0.2 power 6, 0.8 power 6 minus 6. Okay. So when you calculate carefully with the help of calculator, we get the numerical value 0.01696. Therefore, the probability of 4 or more will come in contact of the disease is 0.01696. Okay. Fitting of binomial distribution. A binomial distribution can be fitted to the observed values in the data set as follows. First, this is the first step, find the values P and Q. If P is known, Q will be known, or if Q is known, P will be known. Expand Q plus P power N binomially, that is equal to NC0 Q power N plus NC P power 0, NC1 Q power N minus 1, P power 1, or simply P, plus NC1 Q power N minus 1 into P, etc., etc. Last term, NCN P power N into Q power 0. Using binomial theorem. The second step, in the first step, we have to find the values P from the given observed data. Then expand Q plus P power N binomially. Multiply each term by sum of the frequencies, total number of frequencies, N, capital N, to obtain the expected frequency for each of the random variable, value of the random variable. Okay, so this procedure we need to follow to find the, to fit the binomial distribution for a given observed data. Okay, let us take this problem. The following data are the number of seeds germinating out of 10 on damp filter paper for 80 sets of seeds. Fit a binomial distribution to these data. So first we have to find, as a first step, we need to find mean of this distribution, mean of this. So mean of this distribution is nothing but, there is average. Average is nothing but, for a frequency associated, is nothing but sigma x into f divided by sigma f. That is the mean. Mean is equal to sigma f into x, that is sum of products like this, 0 into 6 plus 1 into 20, etc., etc., up to 10 into 0, divided by sigma f, means sum of the frequencies. This is the one, 6 plus 20 plus 28 plus 12 plus 8 plus 6, etc., etc., etc. So mean is given by sigma x into f, or fx, divided by sigma f, where n is sigma f. So this is n. This is equal to 80. So when you take the sum of these numbers, you get 80. So sigma x into f, that is the sum of the products taken vertically, this into this plus this into this, etc., etc., till here. That is written here, 0 into 6 plus 1 into 20, etc., etc. This makes 174. Therefore, mean is equal to 174 divided by sigma f, that is 80. That makes 2.175. So this is mean. Mean is NP. NP is equal to 2.75. So what is N? Since there are 11 terms, since there are 11 terms here, 10 plus 1, 11 terms, N should be equal to, small n should be equal to 10, 1 less than 10. So therefore, P is equal to 2.175 divided by 10, that gives 0.2175. So this is P. Once P is known, Q is equal to 1 minus P, this is equal to 1 minus 0.2175, this is equal to 0.78. So P is known, Q is known. So P is known, Q is known. Now we have to expand q plus p power n binomially and multiply each term by sigma f r capital N to obtain the expected or theoretical frequency for each of the random variable. Okay, hence the binomial distribution to be fitted is capital N. So you can directly multiply n q to the q plus p power binomial expansion of q plus p power 10 instead of multiplying afterwards individually. So you can directly take n along with this. So n is 80 into q is 0.7825, q is 0.7825, p is 0.2175. So q plus p raised to the power 10. So expanding binomially, so 80 into nc naught 10 c naught into nc naught q power n. So there n is 10, q is 0.778 something. So 10 c naught 0.7825 power 10 plus next term 10 c1 0.7825 power 9 into p is 0.2175 plus 10 c2 0.7825 power 8 into 0.2175 power 2 plus 10 c1 0.7825 power 7, then 3 here, then 10 c4 0.7825 into 2.2175 power 4 plus 10 c5 0.7825 power 5 into 0.2175 power 5 plus 10 c6 0.7825 power 4 into 0.2175 power 6 plus 10 c7 0.7825 power 3 point into 2.2175 power 7 plus 10 c8 next term 0.7825 square 0.21 into 0.2175 power 8 plus 10 c9 into 0.7825 power 1 into 0.2175 power 9, the lastly plus ncn there. So here 10 c10 into 0.2175 power 10. So this will be raised to the power 0, that is 1. So this is the expansion, binomial expansion of q plus p power n, that is 0.7825 plus 0.2175 raised to the power 10. Now I have to multiply n to each number. So this into this, this into this. So to all the terms I will multiply n, and I will write it as the first term 80 into 10 c0 0.7825 raised to the power 10 is 6.88. similarly, the next term will be 19.13. this is come from the multiplication of 80 into this term 10 c1 into 0.7825 power 9 into 0.2175. so that is the value obtained as 19.13. similarly, 80 into the third term will give you this 23.93. fourth term into 80 will give you 17.74 plus fifth term into 80 is 8.63, then 2.87, then 0.66, then 0.1, then 0.01, 0.0068, then 0.00030068 plus 0.0000001. Okay, the successive terms in the expansion, these terms, successive terms in the expansion, give the expected or theoretical frequencies, which are as under. So x, the random variable x, takes the values 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. The corresponding successive theoretical frequencies, so this is the value 6.88 associated with the 6. So while writing, you write the round off and write. So 0 6.9, then for x is equal to 1, 19.13, so written as 19.1. then 23.93 is written as 23.24. Then 17.74 is written as 17.7. Then 8.63, 8.6, 2.87, 2.9, 0.66, 0.7, 0.1, 0.1, 0.01, that is up to one decimal place, it is 0. So this is 0. This is also 0. So 0. 0, 0. Okay. So when you sum all this, we should get 80. So this has been verified. So when you sum all these quantities, you get this frequency 80. 80. Okay. So this is the fitting of binomial distribution to the given observed data. Next problem. Fit a binomial distribution for the following frequency distribution. So x is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The corresponding frequency is 2, 14, 20, 34, 22, and 8. So as a first step, we shall calculate the mean. So mean is given to be sigma f into x divided by sigma f. That is n is equal to sigma f. That is 100 here. That is 100. When you sum all this, you get 100. Then sigma, the numerator, sigma f into x is the sum of the vertical product taken vertically, 0 into 2 plus 1 into 14, etc., etc. So that will give you 284. So therefore, mean is 284 by 100, 2.84. That means NP is equal to 2.84. N, because there are, so N is equal to 5. N is, will change here. N is equal to 5. So since there are 6 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms, N is equal to 5. So therefore, mean is, NP is equal to 2.84. Therefore, P is equal to 2.84 by 5. So this is equal to 0.568. Therefore, Q can be calculated as 0.432. Hence, the binomial distribution to be fitted is N into Q plus P power 5 is equal to N is 100 into 0.432 plus 0.568 raised to the power 5. So Q is 0.432. Q is 0.432. And P is 0.568. So 0.568. So similarly, as we done in the previous problem, we expand this binomially and multiply by 100. So when we do so, we get 1.6 plus 9.89 coming from the second term. This term multiplied to 100 will give you 26.01, then 34.19, then 22.48, then 5.91. So this is approximated to 1.6 to 2, 9.89 to 10, 26.01 to 26, 34.19 to 34, 22.48 to 22, and 5.91 to 6. So when we sum all these, we get 100. So therefore, the successive terms in the expansion give the expected or theoretical frequencies, which are this. For x is equal to 0, it is 2. 2. For x is equal to 1, it is 10. 3, 26. 4, 34. 5, 4, 22. For 5, it is 6. For 5, it is 6. So 0, 2, 1, 10, 2, 26, 3, 34, 4, 22, 5, 6, 5, 6. Okay, so I'm going to stop my lecture here, and then in my next class I will consider the next discrete property distribution. What is mentioned in our syllabus is Poisson probability distribution, which is also a discrete probability distribution. Thank you.